Kiss FM, the story of London's newest dance music station destined to make radical radio.
All those people listening indoors and for those people in here, I want to say goodbye and thank you all for tuning in for the last 2.5 years. And we wish you well and we hope to be back later on this year as a legal station, as a legal Kiss FM. Who knows, maybe on 90 call. It's after 10. 10, 9.
Goodbye, the axes coming through the door in the middle of the breakfast show. So the government tells the pirates, shut down, apply to be a legal incremental station. So kids say, wicked, let's go for it. Incremental or just mental.
Welcome back. London is to get two new commercial radio stations from next year. One will be aimed at young listeners, broadcasting dance music and new record releases.
A few people have been saying, you know, it's like, yes, we've got it, but I haven't actually seen it in black and white. I haven't heard from the IBA. And so I went over to the park to walk the dog. I took the portable phone just in case anybody phoned up with definite news. All of a sudden, the phone rang. It was a journalist from one of the big papers. And he said, I'm phoned up to congratulate you.
But the new contracts awarded by the Independent Broadcasting Authority have ruffled some feathers.
It's an enormous surprise that neither of the two frequencies have been given to a classical music station. A lot of very distinguished people have been, as it were, led on to believe that there would be a classical music station in London.
But while classical enthusiasts may be disappointed, Kiss FM is in the mood to celebrate. It promises a loud launch next summer.
We felt, when we looked at what was missing in London, that both Capital Radio and actually Radio 1 were tending to chase the demographics through into the sort of 25-plus age group, and that there was a danger that the whole younger section of the population might feel themselves disenfranchised because there was no radio station specifically for them. And we felt Kiss's application suggested that they would fill that gap at the younger age end of the market.
Say something happened in the media and we wanted to comment on it, and we commented on it in our show, for example.
As long as it's not what would be considered legally over the mark.
It's all right as long as there's nothing in it that kind of incites people to go out and kind of stab people to death. I mean, you know, kind of, yeah. Fuck the police is probably okay.
I was the early morning person, so I was getting up at 5:30 in the morning. And to get up at 5:30 and to go up a tower block and then to be busted by the DTI at 7:10 after your show's just started. Yeah, that was disappointing. That was real disappointment.
I personally won't go anywhere unless it's got a car park. Well, just for your car. As long as it's got one car park.
It's a brand new property. It's about 8,000 square feet. Passenger lift that goes all the way through the building.
It's definitely the best we've seen so far. The size is right, the price is definitely right. it's actually sort of coming within our budgets, which is that's a bonus, which is more than the others have. It's got the right feel about it. Yeah, it's good, I'm happy with it.
How does this compare with the worst studio you used to work in?
Well, the worst studio we used to work in was something like in the middle there. We'd have a couple of decks done up on a pasting board. I mean, that's what we had years and years ago.
Lovely.
OK.
Let's go for it.
There is two major costs of running a radio station. One is the premises, the other is the people. And we've saved on the premises. We've got the people.
Will you be glad to move into the new place?
I think we'll be glad because there'll be more space and it'll be a little bit more organised. But I think we'll be sad as well because there's a lot of romantic memories attached to this place which we'll be losing.
Right, so you've got the new premises, new technology, desks, and a lot of new friends. Advertising agencies like Saatchi and Saatchi are queuing up not just to kiss you, but to jump into bed with you. They'd act if they came around here. There's not enough room for me and the brothers.
after the great stuff that Saatchi and Saatchi
brought, what was that?
Well, actually, Lindsay was the one that actually came in and found them here at 8 o'clock in the morning.
I arrived at the office, and from the mews, the whole of our mews front, from top to bottom, was covered in inflatable red lips. It was quite incredible. I mean, they scattered all over. Really, it looked incredible.
So you require, for your 10 million, you require a share of 18%, which is quite a significant share. Capital have 34%, so you're looking for roughly 50% of capital's share in the first year, which we think is really quite a hard task and looks a lot more daunting. But how and why are we confident that we can achieve those results? Dance music makes up of over 50% of the top 75 singles. We know that 52% of 15 to 24-year-olds and 41% of 25 to 34-year-olds like to listen to soul in a recent survey. And our own research shows that many 15 to 24-year-olds claim that they would tune into a 24-hour dance music station.
This next idea also forces people to tune in to Kiss FM.
Painful.
Again, Brother Root say, hey, run, go tell your friend.
I had this put on because what is starting to happen now is obviously the two sales guys are out on the road. We don't want names, we don't want anything. What they basically want is to know if there's going to be a soul show, when it's going to happen, when the chart show is. Just a rough breakdown. Because we are going to do these specialist music shows.
Yeah, we're presenter-led, so that we don't formulate a schedule with the music types first and then recruit presenters to fit. We're going the opposite way around. We're putting the presenter into show, but yeah, we'll come up with a grid.
Can I just say as well on this, when we are releasing program information to potential salespeople, that we have to be very careful that the program information doesn't find its way into the press.
Welcome to our new building, which we actually signed the lease to two Fridays ago. And I wanted to have this meeting here with everybody before the petitions go up and before everything happens. And it's just really to get everybody together to say that between us, we're all working for one means, whether it's suits or whether it's creative disc jockeys or whether it's type of office people or whether it's producers or whatever, whether it's no matter what, we're all here for one reason, and that's to go out and go across London and kick some ass on 100 FM from the 1st of September.
I reckon all the DJs will be looked after. They're all safe, but we've got to give it back as well. You know what I mean?
That's right.
We've got to say that. We're standing over there anyway.
We've got to prove. We got the chance now to prove that we can be as good as anybody else that's on there.
Which we are.
Which we are.
What we've got is something different for the rate card. We wanted something that would stand out, that would actually get hung up on the wall.
Yeah, that's going to do that, isn't it?
Media buyers are going to hang this on the wall. They're going to look at it, and what they're going to face every morning when they come into work is the KISS logo and the KISS rate card. Right. The other thing they've come up with for the back of the rate card is just the logo blocked out, very simple. It's going to be black on white. They're going to put spot color there.
And what's that going to be?
Well, it's going to be red.
It's going to be red. Yeah. We don't want the pink. It's
the pink
red.
Didn't work. We tried the pink in some advertising we did for the recruitment. It didn't work, did it?
I mean, a lot of people remember KISS as a pirate. As the whole cachet evolved, there was that slightly sort of underworld feel, that, you know, that excitement generated by being a pirate radio station. and a lot of the major advertisers, people are aiming their campaigns at London's youth, and KISS provides them an ideal way of giving them that cred, that street cred angle that they want to use in their campaigns, but obviously to a much wider audience as well.
So the suits are selling to the suits. But don't rush out and buy the new Mercs yet. There's still a lot of airtime to sell.
A KISS would be a perfect option for you in terms of, because it's reaching, all we're going after is a 15 to 34 year old crowd, dance music fans, and it's perfect for you.
The studios have got to be finished by the 1st of August, and we've got to have at least one studio up and running. We haven't finalised the DJ lineup yet, the daytime DJs. It's the things that aren't actually finished yet that are causing the anxiety.
So if I could just drop by and just drop you off a media pack and just leave that with you, it tells you what KISS is all about.
Soon. I'll get her. She'll buy.
It really is a situation where there's five lines and I think it's eight phones between 30 people. I think it's beginning to tell on people. It's definitely beginning to tell on me.
In fact, you've come at a quiet time. We've usually got five people sitting around the one desk, and it's quite a few people out. We send everyone out now for meetings. Rather than bringing everyone in, we send everyone out for meetings so that it gives everyone else a breathing space.
So if we take it from the top, the format of Capital Radio is chart music. Cumulatively across a week, it has a listening audience of 2.95 million, which equates to about 30% of London. On average, that 30% listens to Capital Radio for 11.7 hours each weekly. Its largest single demographic is adults 15 to 24, and it has a slight male bias.
We welcome the new competition because we all feel at Capital that with the greater diversity of radio available in London, the general audience will be much more aware of radio. The share of the advertising cake should then increase, and so commercial radio will prosper into the 1990s. I don't think we must be in any way insular about the future.
Here at Capital, we've been, in a way, prepared and geared up for the news stations for some time now, imagining when we're on air that we are in a market like New York or Los Angeles, and keeping the music coming, broadcasting with as much pace and enthusiasm and urgency as we possibly can. You can't afford to be complacent anymore, and I think it makes you as a performer better, and I think the listener benefits too. KISS FM are promising dance music. Now, we play a lot of dance music on Capital, so how is their dance music going to be any different?
Well, that's word from the overground, but what about the word from the underground at the other end of the bar?
The way the system has it for a legal station, there cannot be like a pirate station because of the legality of the thing. So at the end of the day, KISS FM is just another, good luck to them, just another legal station in the battle of the giant.
First and foremost, I think that once you become legitimate, the whole game changes. You are no longer pirates, so therefore you lose that atmosphere. I mean, we saw this happen in 1967 when the offshore pirates were mainly closed down. A lot of the broadcasters went into Radio 1 and came across in a slightly different style. I mean, you know, Tony Blackburn, for instance, in those days had been a young, trendy, modern cult hero, but he was soon to become initially very establishment, and then, I suppose, for a short time after that, something that people felt they had heard.
In retrospect, there's always been pirates, and there always will, just that it gets harder to sustain a long transmission and to provide the music now. But we're there, we're sticking our necks out. At the end of the day, KISS was like that. They came off there, and they've now got a license. We wish you well from Fancy KISS, but when our time comes, we'll go off there, and hopefully we'll get a license. And when we do, you'll have to come back and see us again on better locations.
How's this different from the old days? I don't imagine it was quite like this, was it?
It wasn't quite as plush as this, no.
It didn't have anything that looked quite like this, did it? With or without all the bits sitting on the top.
Well, it looked a lot more like a, you know, like a portable disco than a radio station.
Well, it's panic status at the moment, you know, down to just kind of worrying about whether the phone lines are going to be on, electricity and lighting, all that stuff. We're supposed to be moving in on Monday and kind of wonder about that, but, you know, we're moving in, there's nothing we can do about it.
Lynn's desk and area is going to go here, yeah, and his assistant's going to go up the other end.
So, well, and there'll be sort of blinds.
He'll want a blind because Lindsay will cook, otherwise yeah, it's really hot in here.
No, there'll be blinds up here.
We've worked out the weekend and evening programming schedule, and this week we work out the daytime schedule, the last part of the jigsaw puzzle. So by the end of this week, so the first week in August, we'll actually have the daytime schedule and we'll release it to the press.
FM studio. It's all of Kiss FM studio in one box.
We have a lift that's very temperamental. Goes sometimes and doesn't others. Goes up to the third floor, sometimes opens, hardly ever. Days to go, we pick the hottest day to move on. Wonderful.
The hottest day, Gordon. Actually, it's the second hottest day. The hottest is going to be when the station hits the streets. Now it's time to reassure the gentlemen of the press that you can't catch no diseases by exposing yourself to a kiss. Just 18 carat fuck. I'll get a job tomorrow, Mum.
1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. We might have a microphone by the end of it. There's one thing I've got to do before I do anything else. This. This actually comes everywhere, doesn't it? This has been hanging up in the Kiss office for the last 50 days. And we've got 9 days to go. And until we actually come on with our main transmissions. High quality stuff.
You've probably all seen guys wearing a Walkman and they're just singing out loud. It's probably annoyed you. We're actually going to hire people for the whole day to sit in one seat.
We're about 7 days to go and no one's quite sure how it's working. So shall I go with? I'm gonna learn.
Yeah, thank you.
Do you want me to show you how it works? It's one of these here somewhere.
Kiss 100, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is Dave Pearce trying to learn the equipment. They've actually put a new microphone in today. That wasn't here yesterday. And if you're going to ring the radio station as well, this is where the calls will come through on these little blue buttons. And we're not on for 7 days, but they haven't actually connected the phone units yet. And my show's going to have a lot of phone ins in it, so that should be quite interesting.
Cool.
We're from the IBA Quality Control Department, and we're carrying out code of practice tests on the equipment that's in the studios to make sure they come to the IBA's requirement for technical quality.
So how's the patient doing?
Not bad. We have unearthed one or two worms which have been solved, but you always do.
So how many do you reckon to come in now?
From the back catalogues, you have to be looking at another couple of thousand.
At least.
So if we can start with 10, yeah, we've got a library.
Hopefully I'll have enough time, messing around with it to iron out all the mistakes. One or two things maybe in that first hour because of the nerves and the adrenaline, but after that, I think we'll settle in quite quickly. This is a lot more complicated than it looks.
Hectic weekend on, haven't you, because of Carnival?
Oh, that's right, yeah. I mean, we've got the second bay's second birthday party, which is going through till 6 in the morning. And then we've literally got to take the gear out of Dingwalls, put it on the back of the lorry and drive it off to Carnival.
What's happened? Is it a bit fair on the back of the lorry? Is there a...
Well, we're trying to track down Joey J sound system. It's on the loose in London somewhere.
You're our managing director. Where's our sound system?
That's a very good point. That really is. It was here last night.
I'll talk to that. Fine. So number, Rose. Right.
Apparently, Joey's on his way down. Been a slight misunderstanding. The mood's dropped a little bit, but I'm sure that we'll get better eventually.
This is going to be fun.
From Babylon are wearing the Kiss FM hats. That means you have arrived, guys, and so has the big day. The decks are cleared for takeoff. There's nothing that can spoil the fun. Or is there?
Oh, well, what's happening on frequency is that a pirate station has come on our frequency, and there's, 12 minutes to go until we come on air. I don't think we can do much about it, but it seems a strange thing for someone to do.
This is Gordon Mack. There are no words to express the way I feel at this moment, so with your permission, I'd just like to get something out of my system altogether. Rihanna!
Welcome, London.
Do you realise it's taken us 59 months, 465,720 working hours, plus £3.5 million, as well as all of your support over the last 5 years to reach this moment? I'm talking to you from our new studios in Kiss House, which is completely different from the dodgy old studios we used to have in the past. And the odds were against us. None of the establishment fancied our chances. But with the force of public opinion and our determination, the authorities had to sit up and listen and take notice.
It's our first ever on legal radio. Inside of it. And we'll have everything. We'll have Kiss 100 FM. Falling
in love can bring. Thanks to Gordon Mack for an inspired show this morning. Tell me
that I'm back legally, the original sound of Young London. Hear the croak in the voice.
Yeah.
Well, Kiss FM, you are there. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Now, any chance of a job?